Actually, may pamamahan eh. May pamamahan focus. Okay, when, even if the transparokya, what is called, is that the intentional, I see some intentional communities. Kasi, you have to apply eh. It's not automatic that you apply pa yan sa kami. You have to undergo a process pa yan sa kami acceptance sa yan. Which, hindi yan nangyari sa PC kasi automatic yan eh. Because you are there, then you are reversed. It's a matter of how active you are, diba? At saka you become aware. But sa mga lumas, is talaga this process, diba? You have to apply, at saka for recruitment, matapos may mga kamayan, mga initiation process. They are still regulated by the parish priest and are expected to be integrated in the life and mission of the parish. Alam po ninyo, as parish priest, you do not have authority, direct authority over mga rinomates. That is more internal dynamics. Of course, you have to mga busy kasi direct niya address niyo, di ba? They are organic part of the parish. Kaya ano problema dyan, di ba? That is direct niya the authority. But yung mga rinomates or lumas, hindi mo basta-basta pwede makapasok dyan. Kasi meron sa sariling internal dynamics. But they can still be regulated. Insofar as they are in the parish and operate within the parish. So they are regulated by the parish priest and expected to be integrated in the life and mission of the parish. So po ang panawagan sa PCP2, there is the second PCP2 that says that PC is not the use of purpose, but nevertheless, kailangan silang nakipag-ugnay. And to align the trust of the diocese and the parish. But at the same time, patuloy na po ng mga sariling activities. And that is why I post a specific to the members are expected to be actively involved in their respective businesses. Hindi po sabihin na dahil member ka na sa Tapos Progress, hindi na kaya mag-member sa businesses, sa aking mga magkakapitbahay. You can be a member of the same time, a member of the parish, and a member of your neighborhood, kapitbahayan, or EEC. So it's not either or. And that's why that you can also help in your formation and evangelization and provide leadership if needed. So this is a complete expression of your commitment with the parish and the EEC. Ngayon, let's focus on communion and participation in mission. In what way do BDCs participate in mission? Let us remember that the ecclesiology of communion is linked with participation and mission. Kaya nga ayon sa physical participation is a very important aspect of the church as communion. And in the Philippines, participation largely means in evening than lately to participate more fully in the life of the church and its task of mission. Alam mo nito, as I said earlier, one of the important focus sa Vatican II Ecclesiology is participation of the lay people in the life and mission of the church. And once again, this is reaffirmed by PCP2. And this is very, very important nowadays. Bakit? Because kung tayo lang, mga pare, how many are we? We are only 9,000. Mga madre, mga 12,000 plus. Katuliko ilan? 80 million. It is impossible for us to complete our vision kung tayo lang. And that is why it is so important that we have to involve our lay people in the mission of the church. resurrection in the diocese. Because we cannot, even in the years to come, there's no way na there will be a high increase of vocation. Hindi talaga kaya if we just depend on the clergy for the, to fulfill its mission. And that is why na we have to focus on this. Paano ba na ang mga lay people will be able to actively participate in the life and mission of the church? And that is why that when you speak about communion, yan, this is the basis for their participation. Because by virtue of baptism, they are part of the body of Christ and they share in Christ's mission. Okay, we speak about mission, di ba? Participation, when you speak about participation, it's not just participation in anything. Kasi we can participate in kaina, we can participate in yaman. But participation is always linked with mission. Never forget that. Participation is always linked with mission, just as communion is linked with participation and mission. Kaya na, when we speak about the church and these are participatory communities, we are focusing on participation and mission. And this participation in mission is linked to the threefold mission, which was emphasized by Vatican II. As the people of God, prophetic, priestly, and kingly mission. Thus, as communion and community, the leaders and members of the church actively participate in Christ's mission as prophet, priest, and king. Kaya na, participation of the diocese in decision-making, planning, implementation, and evaluation should focus on this threefold mission. First, this is the end of evangelization, catechesis, gospel sharing, and the denunciation of social evil. This is the prophetic mission. To become evangelizing and witnessing communities. Every program, every activity related to the prophetic mission, dapat may pagkakamit lang. Priestly, active participation in worship and in liturgical celebration as worshiping community. Kaya nga, we have to ask a question, ano ba ang mga liturgies at mga emotional practices in our diocese that we need to promote? Ang pangatlo, in the head of a servant in the mission. How is this going to be reflected? Like charity, social action, action for justice, for peace, they think the mission to be a servant community. So always remember this, whenever we speak about participation in mission, it's always related to this threefold mission. We call it prefix bonus. Now, that has to be seen in the programs in the parish at saka down to the level of the BECs. If you notice, na kahit ang mga structures, no? Whatever yung vesting or lahat yan, this reflects the threefold mission. BEC, how are they going to participate in the prophetic mission? Fit with missionary dynamism, BECs carry out the prophetic and evangelizing mission whenever they come together in their homes. Chapel for their Bible service to reflect on the Word of God and their concrete situation. Every time ang patron ay magdalaw sa family and the neighbors come together, and especially when there is a reflection from the Word of God and prayer, that is only part of the process. As agents of new evangelization, they constantly reach out to those who are not active members of the diocese. The seasonal and more nominal Catholics, including the men and the youth. And this is so important because we do not only count Ilan Kai Katoliko. Yeah, there are so many of us, millions, as I get the million people, to realize that may not even levels of participation and attendance, but marami dyan ay nominal, marami ay seasonal. Dumadami na yan, kapagalapit ng fiesta, muliwin at saka yung Misa de Gallo, di ba? So what is important is to be able to reach out to them. And this is why there's an important evangelization. Community-based catechesis are carried out together seminars for youth and adults that deepen their understanding of their faith. Nasabi po sa mission of the BBC as prophet is to become conscience of society. I don't know how many are really doing this, but this is, you know, the idea that they become conscience of society. Because evangelization or the proclamation of the word of God should lead to the formation of the people's conscience, knowing what is right and wrong, what is good and evil. And the witnesses are awakened to the reality of the sinful situation and the culture of death and the responsibility to denounce and resist these evils. For solutions, I have a go. Because in some ways, we prepare to be silent. And being silent, we're supposed to be listening to the people around us. Thus, a Christian community or diocese becomes truly a prophetic community that denounces of evil in its manifestation and announces the good news of salvation, liberation, justice, and all peace. And this is what we strive for. Participation in the priestly mission, we're talking about active participation in the liturgical and sacramental celebration. I was visiting to include worship. What are the new forms of worship? At pati yung mga traditional forms, how do we include them? How do we modify them to make them more meaningful and relevant? Kaya nga, as priestly communities, priests can be involved in renewed worship, prayer meetings in the home, monthly or bi-monthly mass in the chapels, covered court, celebration of the other sacraments at the community level, the festive celebration of their devotions, like Novena, the Rosary, and the rituals of planting and harvesting, the weekly Bible service held in the chapel. These are many of the forms that we adopted at the level of the BBC. Okay, BBC is participation in the social mission. That BECs actively participate in Christ's healing mission. And since his healing mission is expressed in the service, they are servant communities, expressing completely their loving service to one another and those with especially the poor. And that is why they are involved in the new social apostolate for social action. Ito po ang panawagan mo pa sa PCP ito, di ba? Renewed catechesis, renewed worship, renewed social apostolate. Yan po social action, that is, should not be an exclusive work of the social action center. Dapat it has to be reflected at the level of the parish at the level of every BBC. How can the social action program be reflected at some levels of BBCs? Kaya po that BECs can come up with programs and activities to address the problems that they face. May iba po yan. whether it's hunger, poverty, injustice, inequality, violence, and our conflict, like addiction, extrajudicial killings, human rights violation, destruction of environment, natural disaster. And they participate in making the kingdom of God a reality in this world by promoting peace, justice, material development, and liberation of the kingdom of Asia. You know, kinang natin, we thesis, ay hindi na po sana hanggang gasal. Hindi na po sana hanggang gospel is sharing. Dapat yung action part na. It has to be more to respond not just to spiritual needs, but to material needs, and also be involved in the various fields of the social, political, economic, environmental field. Then, as a response to poverty, business, initiative, IGP, then undertaking projects like your projects, microfinance, cooperatives, and cooperative technologies, sustainable agriculture, job referral, etc., etc. Others are already doing this. In fact, sa aming survey, 44% sa respondent dahil sabi na PCP social action na projects. Although it's not the majority, but mayroon akong gumagawa dyan. Ecology. Part of the social mission of PCP is to protect the environment and respond to climate change. Some of the pictures will be mobilized. The PCP is in opinion against logging. Within 2 years, total lockdown was imposed of the whole province because of the absence of the BECs. Of course, it was supported by Cardinal Audience of Rosales when he was a bishop one time. Kaya ang sabi po ni John Paul II, BECs are the instrument of social transformation. That if they put in less privileged and rural areas and become a living, a pleasant life, of care for the poor, and a commitment to the transformation of society. And for this mission, number 51. This is real. This is reality, this is where we want to go. Church and as a PPC is now. Unlike the way in the Bible, our PPCs are not just means of renewing the church, but of transforming our society. So now we turn on the door to the first part of the night. We still have 9 minutes before lunch, kaya let's get your questions or reactions. Questions or just reflection or other things. Maybe on a question, maybe no one has a question. I think this year. Normally, you have to say properly. You don't have a microphone down.
Di ba po marami pa mga process sa promosyon ng diocese at yung mga emerging ministries kasi, dati kasi, nung social action, mga yung ecology, migrants, even the health ministry, even other ministries. Tinawag natin itong mga emerging ministries. Emerging ministries. Tapos ay inihiwalay ito ng maraming dioceses sa social action, nagkaroon ng mga nangyayari directors. At very recently, this is na yung PEC, inihiwalay na rin dun sa social action ministry. Meron na talaga na director ng PEC. Kaya nandito sa Lourdes, sa mga ko, ay the longest time I was attending, we are attending, this is mga PECs na patawag nyo. Previous to that, mas dati na ako. But recently,
nagpura
yung diocese ng Dalo Patron. Kasi nandiyan sila,
tanong nga, kailangan ba talaga ng mayroon sa bagay na mamahala sa BEC?
O okay na nawala? Nandun pa rin, pero
sinagot na yun nung nakaraan.
Iba na rin yung pinakaraan
ng diocesis.
Iba yun yung naman yung pinakaraan
nung nakaraan nung kay hindi sa kanya yung dati yung muna nag-talk ng nakaraan. Pero talaga yung coordinator, meron parang head coordinator.
Hindi rin naman ganun naging successful.
Kasi yung
sa
sa akin ay with these emerging ministries at saka with this flagship program of the diocese, pastoral program of the diocese, Dalo Patron, and with the social action na napakarami ng ibig sabihin na marami na rin programa
sa tayo na
rin ay we just continue, or we just continue with the different approaches. Pinapangalagyan
ng different
communities. Either it is social action inspired, either it is Dalo Patron inspired, either it is ministry on the whole group inspired.
Spiritually, tsaka yung
so,
sila mismo kami.
I suppose,
kaya yung, ano, yung
sa Diyos na sisiguro,
wala ko siya tayo,
And I think it is a, kasi, again, what
important is hindi mo i-offer from the lives, di ba? So sa action, kanya-kanya sila mag-heroes. Bibili ka ng concerts, heroes yung sarili. Family and life, naman, formation, ba na naman, but I think the challenge is, para ba, paano ba ito, mabuo? And I think it is a general look at that sa pastoral planning. How do we fit in together? Kasi if you look at, all of this within social action, diba? Yung projects, coming together para sa patron, prayer meeting, Catholic sharing, at saka yung mga even misa, diba? There are four components of the diocese. Kasi how difficult there are still the same people within a particular neighborhood or community. Maybe by part of the programs or projects, diba? And so on. But I think one is how we work together. Ahang po ko ng name. Kaya lang po, at the level of the diocese, diba? Yung various commissions or ministry, dapat na interpretation, hindi bring kanya-kanya lang ng pagka. Heroes, at the level of the parish, diba? We expect na within the parish, may mga parish level minister or commissions. Kaya lang, it's so important. At the parish priest, of course, yung PPC as a pastoral in a body, together we will come up again. How we work with the coordination of the naman niya, the parish planning. At even pagdating sa PPC level, it's barangay level. Para bang, paano niya mag-i-estigate ang coordination with the people? Kasi ultimately, lahat, whether it's family life program, youth program, even the apostolate, they are to be reflected on the level of the households, communities, the police level. Then it's important that I said earlier that ang challenge is to go beyond just focus on one activity, diba? Dalawa patro, that's just one aspect of the dimension of the PBC. Yung iba, yung social action or IDP or livelihood or yung iba, disaster management. These are dimensions and aspects of that in the same. Kaya dapat nagrinawa natin ang our mission. What is our mission? Na kahit iba-iba ang mga approaches, but dapat klaro natin yung mission. And that we see all of this building up the community. It's 12 o'clock, let's take a break, you can come at 1 o'clock, diba? The reason for the equations are there, I think the vision is going to allow me at, green book for me is exactly, mga palyan, so our primary equations. Know more about the numbers damage in the PPC. So, sa klarisyan.